Ann Kissel.
Yeah. Yeah, so my name's Ann Kissel. I'm married. I have two grown children that are half Greek and half Polish.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. That means they bought a diner, but they can't remember where the hell it is. And as you can see, I have an eating problem. I have a weight problem. I freaking can't wait to eat. But I'm on a great new diet. Looks like some of you are on this diet. It's called the Alcoholics Diet. Woohoo! So exciting. Tomorrow I find out how many days I've lost. So look at you. You're a little guy compared to me. I bet my left titty weighs more than you do. If I were a whore, I'd have to charge double. You know, I put on a string bikini, it friggin' disappeared. That was 3 months ago. I still haven't found that thing. So in case you haven't figured it out, I'm a Roseanne impersonator, a big stretch, really cool. And I went to a Vegas to an impersonator convention, crazy stuff. There was the William Shatner, kept trying to show me the captain's log. Crazy. But I'm not a gambler, so when I go to Vegas, I like to play one of my favorite games. Whore, not a whore. Whore, not a whore. But I also worked in Guam in the Pacific, very cool. And I wanted to look like one of those island girls, so I bought myself a long grass skirt. But when I wore it, no island girl. I looked like the big grass hut she lives in. And I wore that skirt to my first gig. When I walked in, the guys all said to me, "Hey, there's our hula whore." And I said, "Hey, I don't know how to hula." And back at the hotel, they had one of those memory foam mattresses. Ooh. So I took the Tempur-Pedic challenge. The fucking mattress lost. I gave that memory foam Alzheimer's. They're still trying to blow my image out of that thing, I tell you. So I don't know if you can see, but I have a great big red rose tattoo that looks great, huh? Yeah, until I take my bra off. Then it looks like a Twizzler. But that's okay, because it's my husband's favorite candy. And I'm getting a tat on the other puppy, this time a big old penis. That's right. So every year I can watch my penis get longer and longer. How many of you guys can say that, huh? So ladies, remember years ago we had fashion rules, and one of them was if you could hold a pencil under your naked breast, you had to wear a bra, remember? Yeah, well, now I can hold the entire branch the pencil came from. Really sad. Years ago, nice perky 36. Now I gotta buy my bras from Chevrolet. And the scariest part, my bra, my husband's pants, same size. 42 long. Scary stuff. So I went to the doctor the other day, and you know what I hate about going to the doctor? When he takes that wooden tongue depressor and shoves it down your throat. So when he does that, I kind of fake a so he'll think I'm a lady. You guys are smart, you got that one. And I am really pissed at this doctor because I told him, "I want you to give me some major Botox." He must be deaf. He must have thought I said major buttocks. Now look at this. There isn't enough Botox in the world to fill this crap, I tell you. So my husband's sugar is a little elevated, the doctor said. So no more edible candy panties for him. Now I only buy them in whole wheat. No, it's a good thing because now he's getting lots of fiber. That's a good thing. So people, yeah, like I said, I went and got one of those body fat screening tests. I came out to 44%. Yeah, I don't have anything to say about it either. I said, holy crap, I used to buy bacon leaner than that. So I decided to do something about it and went and got one of those Stairmasters. Stared at it for 5 months. That shit doesn't work. So then I put myself on a low-fat diet. Now that really works. See how low my fat is hanging? Yeah, so people, you know, look at me. Sex at my age. Can you imagine? I read a survey the other day that said 70% of women would gladly give up sex for 6 months if they could get a whole new wardrobe. Are you kidding? up for a bag of Snickers.
Well, please put your hands together for Tony Liberati.
Right, I'm feeling good. I'll let you know right up front. I just got back from serving the troops. Thank you. Thanks. I didn't go overseas or anything. I work part-time at Friendly's and some Cub Scouts came
here from Binghamton. Binghamton, New York.
Yeah, and I don't know where the hell I'm going, so I had to look it up on Google Maps. I looked it up, right? Orange, Connecticut, Google Maps, and just came back and said, nah. Good luck. I need to get a GPS because I don't know where the hell I'm going half the time, right? And I don't know if you're like me. Have you ever stopped at a gas station and asked for directions and then completely ignored everything they're freaking telling you? Have you ever done that? Why do we do that, you know? After like the third left, you pretend you're listening. Maybe you give some hand gestures and a nod. Oh, they got Slim Jims. And what you're really thinking is, I wonder how far the next goddamn gas station is. That's why I don't even like giving directions, you know? Like, I think I'm gonna screw it up like it's a crazy quiz, you know? Like, people come up to me, they're like, hey, you know how to get to the post office? I'm like, I don't even live around here. Right? Then I go back to mowing my lawn. Good luck. All right. So I just celebrated my 2-year anniversary. Thank you. Married people here. 2 years. Yes, you know, it's great. I'll tell you, 2 years, you learn a lot about each other. It's very different from like the first 3 months, right? Because the first three months of marriage, she used to play these little games. Guys, I don't know if you're familiar with this, probably. First 3 months of marriage. She used to play this game. It's called Fuck You, I'm Sleeping at My Mom's. Thank you. Yeah, you're familiar with that, right? You know, and like she would play this in the beginning. I'd be like, you know, honey, don't go to your parents. I'm not a dick. You know, we're still BFF. Don't go. Right? Right? But that was back then. You know, now, like after 2 years later, when she'd get ready to go to her parents, you know, I'd be like, honey, see you later. I'm going to get some Guitar Hero with. So, I'm kind of glad I am married now, because the whole shenanigans before you get married, especially you try to get the ring and plan the wedding and all that, but the ring really was the problem. I didn't know what the hell to get half the time, but when I got the ring, you know, my fiance, my wife now, she knew it was coming. Like, she knew, she could smell it, you know? Like, she was kind of like that Gollum character from Lord of the Rings, right? She'd come over, she'd be like, Miss wants the ring. Get away, bitches! My precious! Then she would turn invisible and bite a midget's finger off. So she gets mad at me because I still play video games. Anybody play video games here still?
Yeah.
Yeah, a few people. I love it. I'm never going to stop. I say, honey, I want to experience things I'll never get to experience in real life. You know? I'm like, it's for the same reason why you watch those TV cooking shows. Shit, that's not gonna happen, right? But I'll fully admit I am lazy, right? Guys, you admit that you're lazy? Exactly, no one will speak up. That's how lazy we are. Guys, I'm lazy. You ever go to the refrigerator in the middle of the night, right? You're a little thirsty, parched, 2 o'clock in the morning. You have that big gallon of juice, right? It's full, a little bit spills on the floor. What do you do with that spill? Yeah, a sock pretty much cleans that up, doesn't it? Don't laugh, I spilled a whole gallon of milk on the floor the other day. I put on my bath, rolled and rolled around in that shit. Because it really beats the alternative, you know, for guys in cleaning. We're not going to get 409 in the paper towel. But how about this? The sock really is the last line of defense in cleaning for guys. Guys, we'll walk in to the kitchen, we'll see a little piece of macaroni, right? We'll look to the right, we'll look to the left, and we'll shuffleboard that shit right underneath the stove there. How about when you scrape your plate off in the garbage? Right? The fork accidentally falls in. You're like, screw it, we got others. The worst is grocery shopping. I don't do the grocery shopping. I hate it. My wife does it. And she comes home, and she always gets the plastic bags. And I'm usually laying on the couch, and she'll say, you know, get up. I'm home. Hear the garage door. And it's going to take more than 2 trips. Not for us. Right, guys? You got 13 friggin' plastic bags on each arm. Right? They're stretching the skin. You look like the Ultimate Warrior. Your veins are popping out and shit. Oh, you got gallons of water? No, you put them on. Put them on the thumb, the first finger. I got them. No, I got the door. Get out of the way. I was even lazy in gym class. Did you have to run the mile in gym class? You hated that shit? We used to have guys who would walk around the track in gym class, right? With their shit kicker boots, their flannels, smoking a joint. But that was back then. You could never get away with that now as a gym teacher.